Presidential elections typically end up with a choice between two sides, but the upcoming Brazilian election may be the most polarized dispute in the country's recent history. Today, we look back at Brazil's history to explain why. Before returning to democracy after decades of military rule, Brazil saw plenty of uprisings, polarized elections, and coups. In 1985, still under the dictatorship, Brazil held an indirect election to choose its first civilian president in 25 years. Tancredo Neves won the vote, but died before taking office. His vice president, José Sarney, remained in office until 1989. Under his administration, Brazil enacted a new post-dictatorship constitution, which remains in force today. During this period, Brazilian political forces began to shift. While the dictatorship's Arena party split, Brazil saw a number of new political groups, such as the PT and the PSDB. The 1989 elections was the first time in decades that Brazilians could pick between an array of candidates with different proposals and perspectives. Since then, Brazil went through the Fernando Henrique Cardoso era from 1994 to 2002, and the Workers' Party era with 2 terms for Lula and 1.5 for his successor Dilma Rousseff. At that point, all presidential elections post-1989 were decided between the PT and the PSDB. However, while portrayed as enemies, the two parties emerged during the same historical period, and some of their members worked together in the push for redemocratization in the 1980s. The 2014 election, won by Dilma Rousseff, already started to signal a change. The day after her victory, the PSDB party called for recounts and upturned the democratic process. Dilma was eventually impeached in 2016. And the 2018 election made these shifts entirely visible. Running as a political outsider, Jair Bolsonaro won the election and helped dozens of other far-right candidates into Congress. Suddenly, the traditional balance of power was gone. And now, the 2022 election is bringing about its own unprecedented dispute. Bolsonaro's flawed response to the pandemic, poor economic results, and threats to democracy have largely brought traditional warring factions together. Lula is the frontrunner, and his running mate, Geraldo Alckmin, is a former presidential candidate for the PSDB party, an alliance that would be unthinkable just a few years ago. And in response, Bolsonaro's loyal supporters have become even more radicalized. With no space for third options, October's election is undoubtedly a head-to-head between Lula and Bolsonaro, paving the way for one of the most tense disputes in Brazilian history. Check out the Brazilian Report. Like, share, and comment for more videos on everything Brazil.